Hi everyone, today let's see about the BRICS. Okay, so before starting about the BRICS, we have to know why we have BRICS. See, previously we have stones. To eliminate all the drawbacks of the stones, we have brick. Stone is a natural material we are getting from the rocks. So what are the drawbacks of the rocks? So to get in proper shape, we have to chase it properly. It requires a lot of time and man work, and stones are very heavy, so lift it and do the works and to transfer from one place to another place, it takes hell lot of time. So to avoid all these drawbacks and many other drawbacks, we have made a artificial material that is known as bricks. So today let's see what are the ingredients in the bricks, what is the standard size of the bricks, what is the manufacturing process, and what are the tests done on bricks and its types. Okay, so let's start. So first one is ingredients of good brick earth. So the brick, we have to know what are the ingredients of a brick. So basically silica and alumina are the main ingredients, and we have other remaining ingredients, that is lime, iron oxide and magnesium. So the basic thumb rule is silica is of 60%, alumina of 20%, and remaining other ingredients is of 20%. Okay, so let's see what is the property of this ingredients and what happens if you use excess of it. So basically silica should be of 50 to 60%. The properties, it impart the shape and durability to the bricks. But what it happens if you use greater than 60% of silica, it makes the brick brittle and weak. So the next major ingredient is alumina. So it should be used 20 to 30%. So it imparts plasticity to the brick so that we can mold the brick into any shape. And what happens if you do greater than 30% of alumina? The bricks get cracked. And the other small ingredients are, the first one is lime. It should be used less than 10%. It prevents the brick from shrinkage. So the reduction in size is known as shrinkage. So it prevents the brick from shrinkage. If you use greater than 10% of lime, it loses the shape of the brick. So it will be not in a perfectly rectangular in any of the sides. And the next one is iron oxide. It should be less than 7%. So iron oxide, we can know the brick of the color is red. The red color is due to the iron oxide. What happens if we use greater than 7%? When burning, the bricks changes into dark blue or blackish color. And the final ingredient is magnesia. It should be less than 1%. It imparts little bit yellowish tint, small amount of yellow color, and decrease the shrinkage of the brick if you use excess of magnesia. So it can decay the brick. So these are the five ingredients. So silica 60%, alumina 20%, other ingredients lime, iron oxide and magnesia and more are 20%. So these are the properties. So next we will see the classification of bricks. So this is one of the important question. So classification of bricks. So classification of bricks, we have four classifications. That is first class brick, second class brick, third class brick, and the fourth is known as Gemma bricks or overburnt bricks. Okay. So we have some of the property of the bricks, that is burning, shape, metallic ringing sound, absorption, water absorption, color and efflorescence, and crushing strength. So the first one is burning. So first class bricks are well burnt, and the next one is shape. It is perfectly rectangular. Third one is metallic ringing sound. See, if you want to check whether the brick is of good quality or not, so we will do two tests mainly. One is metallic ringing sound. So what we will do, we will take two bricks and we tap two bricks together so that we can hear a metallic ringing sound. If we hear a metallic ringing sound, then that brick quality is good. So first class brick should always have a metallic ringing sound. And the next one is water absorption test. See, already we know what is mean by water absorption test. We have a bucket of cold water. We will weigh the brick, then immerse the brick in the cold water for 24 hours. Afterwards, we again weigh the brick. So the increase in weight should be not greater than 20%. So then it is known as first class brick. So the water absorption rate is less than 20%. The next one is color and efflorescence. See, the color, we know the color of the brick will be reddish. Efflorescence in the sense, if we see any gray or white patches in the bricks, that is known as efflorescence. In first class brick, there will be no efflorescence. And the final one is crushing strength. See, the test which we'll do in CTM machine. So that is crushing strength. So the crushing strength of first class brick should be 10.5. So the same property for the second class brick. See, burning will be slightly overburnt shape. It will not be perfectly rectangular. In edges, there will be some little bit of damages. And we can hear the metallic ringing sound. Water absorption should be less than 22%. Color, it should be uniform in color. And there will be slight efflorescence. You can see the white or gray patches here and there. And crushing strength, it is 7. Because units are all in Newton per mm square. The crushing strength units are in Newton per mm square. Then we'll see the third class brick. So this third class bricks are not properly burnt. The shape is not perfectly rectangular. If you take two bricks, tap it together, you can't hear a metallic ringing sound like tongue. And water absorption, it should be less than 24%. Color, light red and yellowish tint. And this will be having slight efflorescence. The crushing strength will be 3.5 newton per mm square. And the fourth one is Jamma bricks, or it can be also known as overburn bricks. The shape, it will be in an uneven shape, not in a rectangular shape. And you can't hear a metallic ringing sound. Water absorption will be greater than 24%. Color will be dark blue or black. And we can't able to crush, so the strength will be very less. Okay, then we'll see the manufacturing process of brick. See, this you might be seen in the movie of Vaagai Sudava, how they take the mold and prepare the brick. Okay, so we have four steps. First one is preparation of brick clay. So they have to prepare the brick clay. So how they do is, in this we have four subdivisions. First one is digging. So they dig the soil, but it should be greater than 25 centimeter, because in the top layer we have many unwanted things like grass, plant waste and other animal waste and all. So we have to dig which is deeper than 25 centimeter. And next, after digging that soil, we have to weather. So weathering in the sense, we have to arrange it like a heap, which will be in a triangular position. So it should be, the height should be 60 centimeters to 120 centimeter heaps, so that if there is any water content, it will naturally evaporate. And the third one is blending. Blending in the sense, we have to mix the bricks in the proper proportions. Mix the all the ingredients in the proper proportion. That is known as blending. See, if we buy a mixer, we have another option of blending. That is, it will just mix it in a proper proportion. And the fourth one is tempering. So what is tempering in the sense? So after blending, this will be like a solid particle. We can't mold it and all. So we have to add water, which should be of 30% of the weight of the soil in pug mill. So that is known as tempering. So this is the four stages that how we prepare a brick clay. That is, we will dig greater than 25 centimeter. And for weathering, we will have a heap of 60 centimeter to 120 centimeter for weeks or months. And then we mix it in a proper proportion, that is blending. Then we'll add 30% of the weight of the soil to the water. That is known as tempering. Then what we will do is, we will do molding. Molding in the sense, we can do it by hand molding or machine molding. So molding, in the sense, we are giving proper shapes to the brick. So that is known as molding. So it can be done in the ground or on the table, hand molding or machine molding. With the help of the machine, we can get the proper shape of the brick. And the next one is drying. Drying, in the sense, we have to remove the water content from the brick. So we can do in two ways. One is natural, another one is artificial. Natural, in the sense, we can arrange a brick in such a way that we will have lots of gaps so that air can pass through and remove the water content from the bricks. Another one is artificial. So artificial we can do in chamber dryers and all. We can remove the water content. And the fourth one is burning. So burning, which gives the strength and durability to the brick and which makes the brick harder. So it can be done in clamp, which is in an open space, or in kiln, it is in a furnace or oven. So by doing this four step, we'll get the brick. And we know the standard size of brick. What is the standard size of brick? That is 19 by 9 by 9 centimeter. So you can have a, you can think, see, if it is an artificial material, we can make it for 20 by 10 by 10. Why we are making it for 19 by 9 by 9? See, that is because we have to do mortar. We have to place a brick, we'll have a mortar, then we place another brick. Okay. So when we have the brick with mortar, it will be having the size of 20 by 10 by 10. Okay. So you can, wait a minute, it is 19 by 9 by 9. See, if you take a brick, when you look the brick, whether it is in rectangular shape or a square shape, if it is in 19 by 9 by 9, it should be of a square shape. So what you do, you just take a tape or just take a scale, measure the size of the brick and let me know. Okay. So these are the manufacturing process. And the final is test on brick. So we have mainly three tests: water absorption, compressive strength, efflorescence. So first one is water absorption. We know how to do the water absorption test. For the good quality of brick, it should be less than 20%. And compressive strength, we know, we will place the sample of brick in CTM machine and we allow the brick to crack. So the good compression strength should be 10.5 Newton per mm square. And the third one is efflorescence. So what we will do, efflorescence. Efflorescence is nothing but the gray or white powder patches appear on the brick surface. So what we will do, we will take 150 mm of glass dish container. We will pour 25 mm of water. Then we'll place the brick. On drying, we will check whether the brick will be having gray or white patches or not. Then we will classify whether it is having no efflorescence, light, moderate or heavy. See, afterwards, we'll take that brick out. If the exposed area to the water doesn't have any gray or white powder patch, then we can tell there is nil efflorescence. If less than 10% of the exposed area of brick is having some patches, we can call it as light efflorescence. If 10 to 50% of the exposed area is having patches, then we can call it as moderate. And if it is greater than 50%, we call it as heavy efflorescence. Okay. So this is all about the bricks. So you do one thing, you just check the dimension of the brick and let me know. Okay. So that's all for today. This is all about the bricks. Thank you.